Hello guys, welcome to my channel. In this video we will learn how to write material and method section. So if you haven't watched the previous videos like how to write introduction and how to write abstract of a research article, please go down in the link and check those videos. It would be very useful if you already know that how to write introduction and abstract. So if we basically divide the overall data into two sections, so the first section would be material. So as we know, in this first paragraph we have to mention the materials that we have used in our experiment. So we can mention, like if we are talking about the agriculture experiment, we can mention the variety name and we can mention this the location where the experiment was done, like it was any experimental site of any university, or you can also mention the environment like the climate and the weather and the temperature if you are doing agronomy experiment. So you have to mention the details which you have used as material section. So usually there is only one paragraph of material section, so you can give all that necessary information like the brief I have mentioned in this. So the next part is the method section. The method section overall can be divided into three parts. So we can just divide in order for our own convenience. The first part is instrument, and the second part is chemical, and the third part is protocol. So if we specially talk about instruments, so we have to mention that which instrument, like which model, like you are using electron microscope, which model and which company. Even you have to mention the company name. The idea basic writing every detail is that if someone wants to reproduce your experiment, he can use same model or same company to buy or to purchase different things to repeat an experiment. Or if he is not using same model or same company, so there can be a little variation. So the next part would be the chemical. So you have to mention the supplier, like from where did you get your chemical, like you have used any acid or any chemical. You have to mention its complete name and item number and supplier, like which chemical company you have used. And the third important part is the protocol. So protocol is most important. You have to mention each step, like the step one, step two, what you did in step one and what you did in step two. So overall this is the theme, how the information flow from material and method section. So here we will see further details how to write material method section. So in overall, in a scientific paper, it is the bulk of all scientific paper. I mean, if whatever you have used your all techniques, you can just use one by one. So it usually includes the materials. I have already mentioned that what you have used in your experiment or what you have examined, like humans, animals, tissue preparations, all you can give your details of materials, whatever you are using according to your own experiment. And in the method section, I have already mentioned that you have to refer how subjects and objects were manipulated to answer your research question. Like the how the calculations were made, how the data was analyzed, this can be done in method section. So this is the third important, that is the statistical, historical sampling and theoretical techniques you used. So you can also include equations, algorithm, flow charts, table figures for appropriate description. But sometime depending upon the research area, maybe there are some things which don't need, but it is a general flow. You can decide either it is important or not. So if we specifically see the examples, so in the material method section, like the here we can see materials, they are the culture media. They were obtained from the life technologies, like here we have mentioned the name of company, like it was the Geitherberg's MD, and the ochadic acid was purchased from Alexis company, Switzerland. Like the every detail you have to mention, that like these antibodies were phosphorylated, MPPK were purchased from New England Biolabs, and even you can mention the complete detail and how the induction was cell death was confirmed. You can mention like the clear subheading reference, and even sometime you can use the reference like cell death was induced as described previously. This is called citation. So here you can cite the previous article if you are exactly using the same way as it was reported previously. But if you have modified something, you can use here that it was used with little modification, and you can mention here all the modifications. And here, light, let's suppose like you use light and electron microscopy, you can mention like step 1, step 2, step 3 each. And like here you used epoxy resin, that from where you did buy. And if you are using statistical analysis, you can also give examples of statistical analysis, like a student t-test was used and what was the p-value, all the information you have to mention. So hope so now you have understood the basic idea. So now let's see an example of real material and method section. So here is a one of my paper. Here in we can see that this is material and method section of published research article. Here we are using a mutant LMM915. How we get, I mean, this is the variety name and its characteristics, and where it was like in the Chengdu city, Sichuan province, Lingshui county, and Hainan province of China. So here are the method section. Here there is the histochemical analysis, and here I have mentioned that I have described with the previous reported method, and here is the complete detail how I checked chlorophyll contents, and here is the inoculation of pathogens and disease resistance assay, complete protocol step by step, and even I have mentioned the previous citation. You can also use this, but if you are discussing your thesis, you have to give all the details in of each and every step completely. Here is the method of DNA extraction and RNA extraction, and so on. Here is the genetic analysis. It may depends upon for your experiment. Maybe sometimes you don't need, like here it is the sequence analysis. So even I have mentioned the name of software we use, like the DNA version 6.0. Even this 6.0 is also important because DNA man has several versions, and like the alignments of amino acid were performed using the software Clustal 2. So this is the way how you write your material and method section. So if you have any question, please tell me in comments, and hope so you have liked my video. So, and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.